Good morning, everyone. It's Sebastian Comte again. This time, I would like to present the work we've done on peri-urban deer management. This presentation covers the wild deer component of the project Management of Wild Dogs and Deer in Peri-urban Landscapes. This project was led by Biosecurity Queensland and New South Wales Department of Primary Industries. But this project was a great teamwork, and I'd like to acknowledge everyone that was involved, especially the local collaborators in Queensland and New South Wales, without which we couldn't have access to all this information. Increasing presence of deer in peri-urban areas across Australia is a major concern. Peri-urban landscape, by definition, are densely inhabited, which are often like small holdings, which means managing invasive species requires coordination of a lot of stakeholders, which sometimes have different agendas. It also means that the impact of deer can be very diverse and sometimes difficult to quantify. Vehicle collision is obviously a major concern, but deer are known to damage gardens and sometimes conservation projects or reserves. In some places, illegal hunting has been known to create stress for landowners, while deer can also create health and safety issues in terms of water quality, for example. Because of this complexity, specific protocols and tools are needed to control and to monitor those peri-urban deer population and the management programs. Classical methods like aerial surveys, spotlight counts, or even camera traps are not adapted to peri-urban areas. So one alternative is the use of fecal pellet counts. And this method provides an index of abundance, which can then be used to monitor changes in deer populations over time, or to link those changes to management operations. This is an ideal method for peri-urban areas because it has very low impact and high acceptability. That means you can use this method in almost any habitat, even like private gardens. It only requires a little equipment, a piece of string, two pegs, and a GPS, as you can see on the right picture. This is everything you need to do the monitoring, which means this method is pretty cheap and relatively easy to run. Involving local collaborators like Water New South Wales in the bottom right can also reduce the cost of the monitoring. The first site where we tested this method was Western Brisbane. There, the city council decided to remove rusa deer from specific suburbs with a target of 100 individuals per year. After 3 years of control operation, using 35 transect where we counted fecal pellet count, you can see on the right that the first year, the population remained relatively stable, but the activity decreased in the last 2-3 years, which was a good sign that the control operation had an impact on the rusa deer. Rusa deer are also present south of Sydney in the Illawarra region, and they are causing a lot of issues with the community, both in terms of economic impact and health and safety. In the last 10 years, the city council and the local land services decided to implement a management program involving contract shooters, and they removed 4,700 rusa deer over the years. As you can see on the left plot, the effectiveness was pretty stable over time, over the last 10 years, the number of deer killed per night remains stable. But the effectiveness of the ground shooting was really high during the rut season, where male are known to be less wary and moving a little bit more in the open areas. We tested the animal welfare outcome of using contract shooters in peri-urban areas. And the main finding was that this method was had a good standard in terms of animal welfare outcome, but there was large differences between shooters, and that means to ensure the best outcome, you need to make sure that every shooter involved has a good training and maintain its training over time. Also, new technologies like thermal vision equipment has the potential to improve the welfare outcome of ground shooting in peri-urban areas. Because the area was much larger than Brisbane, we started the monitoring with 30 transects in 2012, but we increased the numbers to reach 108 by 2021, which allowed us to cover more ground and to have a better spatial coverage of the area. Over the 10 years, you can see on the right that the populations decreased at the beginning and then stabilized over time until the last few years where we saw another decrease in sightings. But when you look at the map, those sightings were were not homogeneous, and we still have hot spots after 10 years. Try to understand why that happened. We used different tools, and specifically we collected tissue samples from deer across the region to have a look at the genetic structure in the population, and that allowed us to identify or to suggest the presence of three different units or subpopulation that could be targeted by the management. We were then also able to compare the abundance with the genetic structure and community complaints collected by the city councils, and we can see that typically on those maps there's a match between a change in genetic structure and high complaints and high abundance. So those are tools that, when put together, can really inform the management. With this project, we've shown that fecal pellet count was an effective method to monitor deer population and deer management programs in peri-urban landscapes. But when possible, a diversified monitoring strategy should be used due to the complexity of the landscape. Emerging technologies like genetics and thermal vision equipment and drones will certainly help widen the number of tools available. In terms of control operation, professional ground shooting is definitely the preferred methods due to health, high standards in health and safety. But attention should be given to maintaining a good training for all contractors, as well as the use of thermal vision equipment when possible. Operations should follow seasons and specific deer ecology as well to improve the efficiency. Thank you for your attention.